Fluids. How many counted the water as a fluid system? This water sitting right there. Okay, that's good. Yeah, the water here is one of them. How about the oil? Separate fluid system? Yeah, separate density. Both of those are liquids. Gases are also fluids. Turns out there's gas right there. There's air there, there's air there, and there's air up there. And those pockets of air are not connected to each other. They are three separate fluid systems. This pressure right here has nothing to do with what's going on in that cup over there. Those of you who, you might have a feeling, I always have a feeling when I look at this, that this must be a pretty high pressure inside this cup right here, because it's pushed the water level lower than it is right there. Something has pushed the water level down, it feels to me like, at least that's one way to think of it. And so that must be a pretty high pressure inside there. Conversely, this water level is pulled all the way up to there, higher than on the outside, so that's probably a low pressure. Now, proving that with this equation is, of course, with this idea, proving that with this idea is, of course, the point, not just, oh, it feels like this ought to be a high pressure and it feels like this ought to be low. You ought to be able to prove that it is. But those little air pockets are three separate fluid systems. They are unconnected from each other. They're all static, but they're not connected to each other. You can't go, you can't pick a point in here and a point in there and go through the same fluid system to get there. The only way to get there is to go through the oil and the water and then back up again, and that's going through a whole, that's traversing too many fluid systems. This is a separate fluid system, this air here, that air here, that air there. The oil is, the water is, how many is that? Five so far. Any others? There's one other. I don't think I even mentioned it, but it's there. The surrounding air on the outside. There's really six. I would have taken five or six if I was actually judging these answers. Because you can easily forget the one outside, although you shouldn't. Because if I ask you what the pressure of the water right there at the top of the water is right on the outside, what would you have told me? What would you have? What would you say? What's the pressure on the outside of the water right there? Yeah. Yeah, one atmosphere is a good guess at that. I mean, these you don't generally put. Running out of power. You don't generally put water upside down in a vacuum. For one thing, you can't. The water is just going to slowly boil away until there's a pressure up above it, vapor pressure of something, liquid water in particular. So that brings me to essentially number three. Even though I didn't label them this way, I'll put number three over here. The pressure at one side of an interface between two fluids is the same. Oh, how do I want to put that? I will put pressure at the other side of interface. But I better explain that, because I'm not sure that is quite as clear as I'd like to write it. This water right here connects to the air. There's an interface between the water and the air at the surface of the water. The air is at one atmosphere. Because this is an interface between two fluids, the water at the top is one atmosphere. The pressures are the same when two fluids touch each other. Maybe that's the best way to say it. The pressure right here of the water, at the top of the water inside that cup, the pressure right there is the same as the pressure of the air right above it. It's another way to say that. That actually gives you essentially a proof that this is a high pressure, because here, up at the top of the water here, the pressure is 1 atmosphere, and the gravitational potential energy is higher than the water right here. So as you go from here, the top of the outside water, to the top there, gravitational potential energy goes down, because inside that cup, the water level is lower. What does that tell you about the pressure? This pressure is 1 atmosphere. What's that pressure? Greater than or less than or equal to 1 atmosphere? It's greater than. The gravitational potential energy here is lower than here, so the pressure here is larger than the pressure there. Gravitational potential energy is lower inside that cup, cup number one, the surface of the water, than it is on the surface of the water outside. And so the pressure is larger. And that means the pressure in this air is larger than the pressure than 1 atmosphere. Because the height, there, sure, there's a height change, but how much does the pressure change, the pressure of air change when the height changes by, you know, a little bit, the size of a cup? It's 1,000 times smaller than the pressure changes due to the height changing in water. Just because air is so small a density that you don't really have to worry about gravitational potential energy changes for air. Yeah? So which pressures are the same? Well, we already ruled out pumps, current, and kinetic energy because the problem is static, right? So this is zero, that's zero, and that's zero. So all we're talking about is gravitational potential energy and pressure. In this water, everything at the same height has the same gravitational potential energy, and so has the same pressure. So in this water, everything up here at the surface is the same height and is in contact with the air at 1 atmosphere. So everything up here is 1 atmosphere. Everything lower has lower gravitational potential energy, so it has higher pressure. So everything there, everything down here is that's lower has a higher pressure, that's lower in location, farther down. But everything at the same height has the same pressure. So you'll notice that this line is drawn kind of there, and this is really all at the same height. So all of those heights happen to be the same pressure. In fact, there's a FNT after the first DL that has this picture, and thinking of all of those right there, all right, running out of battery. Thinking of these all as the same height, these right here, because the water is the same height right there, they all have the same pressure. That's a good way to start in how you answer that question. Any other questions on this one? Separate fluid systems require a separate equation. So if you really wanted to finish this completely and calculate all the pressures everywhere, you would need 6 equations. And you would need to match all the pressures at the interfaces in order to straighten all of that out. So I'm going to do this one in a second, but I was going to ask you some questions about it first. Air flows from left to right in this horizontal tube. By the way, there's some water down in these connections that are open to the horizontal tube. Same as that picture right there. There are water levels. These water levels are open to the air right now. So it all turns out they're the same height. Why are they the same height? Because they're the same pressure. They're all open to the air. There's nothing flowing anywhere. And so the air everywhere in here is at one atmosphere, basically. And because the air is at one atmosphere, the top of the water level is at one atmosphere, and so they're all at the same height. No gravitational potential energy changes in the water right now. Suppose I have air flowing through here to the right. I push air past here. We're going to pretend air is incompressible, even though it isn't. Your answers will be okay anyway, but I like to just not let that complication show up. The water in here is going to change its levels when there's air flowing. It's not going to be level anymore. At some point, I'm going to ask you to predict the new levels, but for right now, I'm not going to draw them the correct way, or else your predictions might match what I drew, and I would rather you predict it on your own. My question here, though, is at which point is the flow rate of air, total volume of air per second, largest? Let's pretend air isn't being compressed here. Like the pressure, whatever pressure differences there might be, are not so big, and so there's not a big compression of the air. Think of the air as incompressible. At which point is the flow rate, the total amount of air per second, largest? Talk about it for a minute or so. I'll ask you.